This segment brought to you by SureCrop, liquid crop nutrition delivered right to your farm.
We're back. Now Duane is with Brett Crosby of Custom Ag Solutions, talking about how to improve marketing and price risk management.
Duane Towes joining you once again here on Ag AM in Kansas, and an opportunity to catch up with Brett Crosby, talking a little bit about the really important things in terms of making money for producers. Ultimately, everybody likes to see a bank account that looks better at the end of the year. A lot of things that go into that, Brett.
Absolutely, and we have become as cattle producers very good at producing beef. We produce more pounds of beef now with 30 million head of beef cattle in the country than we did in 1976 with 45 million head. But we still have a ways to go on focusing our efforts on marketing and price risk management.
Talk a little bit about your company and what you try and help producers do.
Custom Ag Solutions is an economic research and outreach company based out of Cowley, Wyoming. We specialize in risk management, outreach, and research projects. And one of the research projects that we've done and spent a lot of effort on is the beefbasis.com website, which is a price forecasting website for calves of various weights and types in various locations at various dates across the country.
We're thinking about expectations. Once we have something or a goal in mind of where we should be, then we can start making some decisions on how to get there.
Right. The price discovery mechanism that we're used to focusing on is the feeder cattle futures market in the cow-calf business and stalker business. And the feeder cattle futures is the market's expectation of what 800-pound steers are going to be worth in the 13 state area that make up the feeder cattle index. That doesn't necessarily mean that 500-pound heifers are going to be the same price, which has always been that's always been the challenge for producers. Looking at the feeder cattle futures and saying, okay, well, what does that mean for the cattle that I sell? So the beef basis forecast models are designed to help producers do just that, and they're designed to help producers look at the cattle futures and say, okay, here's what the futures are. Now I want to know what my cattle are going to be worth in Topeka on October 27th, weighing 620 pounds, for example. And so they can plug that in, and our models will use that information and the current feeder cattle futures market and return a forecast range that says, okay, if the feeder cattle futures remain the same, then this is what we forecast those calves to be worth.
Think about the marketing side of things. I think that's probably one of the least favorite things that cattlemen do. They're pretty good at saddling up and taking care of mama cows. But ultimately, when the dollars and cents, as long as we get a live calf on the ground, then the marketing side of it is where the majority of the funds can be gained.
Absolutely. The price received is just as important as the number of live calves that you actually sell. Yeah, if the price goes down by 10%, that's just like losing 10% of your calf crop. It's really uncommon for people to lose an extra 10% of their calf crop, but it's not uncommon at all for the price to fluctuate 10% even within a given year. And that's where the opportunity comes in. We can take the opportunity of those fluctuations and use the futures market as an offsetting investment or a hedge, we call it, if we understand what we're doing. Farmers, ranchers, I think have not wanted to focus on marketing because they have this feeling like there's nothing that they can do about marketing. They're price takers. We've been told we're price takers, we're commodity producers, and so we're going to be price takers, when in fact the ability to hedge changes that a little bit. And B, a lot of farmers and ranchers don't participate in the futures market as a hedging instrument, just because they don't understand it. And that's what we're trying to change.
Our thanks to Brett Crosby joining us here on Ag AM in Kansas. Jamie, we'll send it back to you.
Thanks, Duane. Come back after the break for this week's Kansas Farm Bureau update.